I don't know about you, but for me, it's crucial to stay productive during quarantine. For example, at the start of the year, I bought a journal to keep tabs on every book I've read and every film I've seen. But now I'm just keeping a list of every porn I've watched that's troubled me, starting with hardcore kissing. It's not what you think. And while we're all trying to do the most to stay sane during the pandemic, the president is doing literally the least.
The Navy Blue Angels will be performing air shows over America's major cities. What we're doing is we're paying tribute to our frontline healthcare workers confronting COVID.
Many people in America's major cities are locked indoors. The only thing they can see out their window is the creepy neighbor who does bottomless yoga. Flying a squadron of jets costs at least $60,000 per hour. The only way spending that kind of cash makes sense is if they're dropping PPE over hospitals and also Nintendo Switches over my house. Look, we should absolutely honor essential workers, but not with military jets or by calling them heroes while paying them criminally low wages. We should actually be protecting them. And there's one group of workers who really need our protection right now. The Postal Service. Look, I know it's hard to get excited about the Postal Service because it's just like always there, quietly doing his job. But the Postal Service is hot as hell. How hot? I mean, the workers wear knee shorts. They give it to us in the rain, sleet, and snow. And they're the only federal agency built entirely on the principle of licking stuff. Unfortunately, as badly as the government is neglecting other frontline workers, it saved the biggest fuck you for the Postal Service.
The U.S. Postal Service is sounding the alarm. Without financial assistance from the government, it will be out of cash by the end of September when House Democrats ask for $25 billion in funding during the stimulus talks. Sources tell CNN the Trump administration rejected the idea.
The Postal Service is a joke because they're handing out packages for Amazon and other internet companies. And every time they bring a package, they lose money on it. If they raise the price of a package by approximately four times, it'd be a whole new ball game. But they don't want to raise because they don't want to insult Amazon.
That wouldn't insult Amazon. The only way you can insult Amazon is by accidentally calling Alexa Siri. They weren't supposed to know about each other. Last week, Trump threatened to block coronavirus aid for the U.S. Postal Service unless it hikes its prices immediately. Specifically, the president thinks the post office is undercharging Amazon for deliveries, something his own administration has debunked. Trump is obsessed with Amazon and hates Jeff Bezos, and not for all the good reasons to hate Jeff Bezos. It's because he owns the Washington Post. Being mad at Jeff Bezos for owning the Washington Post is like being mad at George Bush for painting wrong. This is the worst possible time for us to have to suffer through another one of the president's vendettas. It's an election year, and with coronavirus outbreaks expected to continue through the fall, the Postal Service may be the only thing that could save our democracy. This November, we need universal vote by mail. After Wisconsin Republicans refused to postpone its primary or expand mail-in voting, the state saw dozens of coronavirus cases among voters. The state also faced backlash for its poorly timed get-out-the-vote campaign, Catch Voting Fever. Republicans resist mail-in voting because they're afraid it will help Democrats, but there's no evidence to confirm that. Mail-in voting helps everyone. Old people, young people, late-night TV people. Who would have liked being invited to Zoom with Lady Gaga, but are fine that didn't happen? Five states already vote, mostly by mail, including Utah, a state so conservative, each ballot has to marry the ballot box before being inserted into the slot. And even though the Postal Service has been in financial trouble before, in 2020, it's in serious danger.
It's having a dire impact on the public postal service itself. Small businesses aren't mailing. Advertisers aren't mailing. Those who want to send birthday cards can't get the birthday cards and mail it.
He's right. I ran out of birthday cards, and I had to send my 7-year-old nephew a card saying congratulations on your pregnancy. He doesn't even know where babies come from yet. So I wrote it on the back. Due to the pandemic, mail volume is down by nearly a third. More than 1,200 workers have tested positive for the coronavirus, and many are concerned about the lack of supplies and care provided on the job. Post office workers shouldn't be afraid of not having basic supplies. The only thing they should be afraid of is being stalked by wild turkeys.
Over the last month, he's acquainted himself quite well with the truck and now has started to follow me. He did startle me. He kind of jumped up and flapped his wings, feathers, or whatever it is. I'll be honest, the beginning was get away from the truck, but now I'm not even speaking to him.
Look, if he wants to talk to me, he can visit me after work and face me like a man. Turkey. A turkey man. The Postal Service is one of the only federal agencies directly authorized in the Constitution, and it's one of the most democratic institutions we have. It's legally required to deliver to anyone, anywhere, at the same price, which is great, because I've got a lot of relatives around the country and a lot of congratulations on your pregnancy cards. The crazy thing? Grandma was. And believe it or not, the Postal Service doesn't cost taxpayers anything. It's funded entirely through the sale of its services and products. That's why it's always coming out with new stamps, like the upcoming hip-hop commemorative series. Which is fitting, because the post office was kind of a hip-hop pioneer.
Now that's easy to say, and it sounds just fine. But let's put this question right on the line. What is the zip code, a postal quirk? What does it do? How does it work? If you'll lend an ear, we'll be glad to explain how the zip code eases your postal pain.
This is the weirdest person I've ever been attracted to. I want to ruin him by showing him the way we have sex now, like in the 2020 way. Does that make sense? He would snap like a piece of balsa wood. He's not ready for it. Like, what he thinks is crazy is so far from crazy now. Unlike the rapping in that video, the Postal Service is actually good. It even has the highest approval rating of any federal agency, with 91% of both Democrats and Republicans viewing it favorably. But even if their voters like it, Republican leaders hate when the government actually works. They've been trying to undermine the Postal Service for decades, going back to 1982, when Ronald Reagan signed a law requiring NBC's Thursday night lineup to feature at least one asshole mailman at all times. More recently, Republicans have fought to lower wages, reduce benefits, eliminate routes, and cancel Saturday service, and ultimately, they want to privatize the post office. It's ridiculous to expect the post office to be a money-making enterprise. It's a public good. Expecting the Postal Service to turn a profit is like expecting public libraries to sell the right to use their bathrooms. Going into a library to punish the bathroom and not read is our American right. Furthermore, private companies like FedEx and UPS often rely on the post office to do last-mile deliveries to save them money. And while we're comparing FedEx to the Postal Service, ask yourself this. Can you really trust a company that did this to Tom Hanks? Oh, hello, Tom Hanks. Perhaps you've noticed I've been making lots of references to you lately. Just trying to get your attention so you'll do my show or donate some of your blood to me. I'm not sick. I just think it'll make me a nicer person. Since the pandemic has made it so important for people to stay home, the post office has become a desperately needed lifeline delivering food, medications, and supplies. It can do that because it reaches all 160 million addresses in America. That includes places that aren't profitable for private companies to serve, which is why rural communities will suffer the most if we lose it. When the nearest pharmacy or hardware store is 30 miles away, the post office becomes indispensable, especially for elderly people who can't drive, like my grandma. It's not because she's too old. It's because she's too pregnant. The fact is, the Postal Service is in dire straits. We can't fix it without the government's help, but there are some things we can do. In addition to putting pressure on our representatives, we can buy stamps. You don't even have to use them to mail stuff. I used mine to wallpaper my bedroom. No matter where I am, I can always feel Big Bird's eyes on me. Supporting the Postal Service is so important. Full Frontal is going all in designing our own line of stamps that encapsulate our show in one square inch. They're real postage that you can use, and we're asking you to help us choose the design. Just go to our Twitter page at Full Frontal Sam B to vote on one of our super cool stamps created by our graphics team. We're revealing the winner tomorrow and giving them away for a limited time at SamanthaB.com/stamps. They're absolutely free. Wait, I just found out the results are already in, and oh my God. The winner is Pregnant Grandma? Doesn't even have the name of the show on it. Okay, well, democracy. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button. You might be the 1,000,000th subscriber, or the 1,000,000th and 1th, or tooth. I mean, who's counting? I am. Please subscribe.